My name is Wendy de Boer, and I'm a flight attendant. I love my job and traveling, but my other big passion is photography. On my trips, I meet photographers around the world to do a photo team-up with them. Together, we visit the most beautiful places in their city, and through our lens, we learn more about photography, culture, and life. This is where my project Shoot with the Local came about. Join me on my new adventure.
Hi there, I'm Ramiro, a photographer from Mexico. Welcome to my country. Photography is about who you are and why you pursue the profession of doing photography, even if you are a dilettante. In the end, I am speaking about myself. Everything is about encounters. The deepest encounter is encountering yourself. And the best way to have memories is having these encounters that you never forget. So the art gives the chance to become a child. I feel this tremendous need of expressing what I feel. By no means I can express what I feel perfectly. The closest thing I find was photography. In my initial approach to photography, I read a book about Jean-Loup Stief, a great photographer from France. I read how he was obsessed with the time, how he captured the time. That was the very first bright click with photography. We go to a market called Medellin, like the city of Colombia.
Wendy,
del país de los tulipanes. When you encounter people, when you have the chance to meet people, always you have to deal with how you see and you perceive the world. So in the end, you are not capturing the world, but what your perception of the world is. Mm-hmm. Say that the photo itself is just a document that shows what an evidence that you've been in a place, but behind that photo is a story, a human story.
Wendy, this is La Condesa. A lot of streets on this area had the name of capital cities of Europe. Mm-hmm. So we are in the intersection of Mexico and Amsterdam Street.
Did you ever sell one of your photos?
Yeah. For example, National Geographic paid for me.
Oh wow!
Yeah.
To create it, or
it was not much, but enough to do the traveling and those things. Mexico selling photos as an art. It's quite complicated.
People. I think it's everywhere.
Yeah.
I think it's everywhere.
They look more for names than for the picture itself.
That's it. Yeah, that's it.
We have your National Geographic project about the Tastuanes.
Yes, but this specific came to National Geographic thanks to Instagram as well, because the great photographer Maggie Stever came to see my pictures of the circus. She wrote to National Geographic in Washington, D.C. But they have already an assignment for a circus. But the chance of the door was open to offer them another project. So I offered the Tastuanes, and they quickly accepted that to be published in a digital version. Being a documentary photographer is not something that I think on. What I was trying to convey is this idea of moving on the audience. I was not aware about that. For example, circus came to my life very childhood. I grew up in a place where we have no more options than a circus every year. So I came to know families. I get inside of their lives. This is not in my photography.
Well, but I did see one of your projects.
Yeah, but it's what I say is that what I was looking for is having this chance of exchanging the emotions with them. So when you approach people, you really need to rely on your intuition. So when I approach a couple, I approach an old man, or I approach a dancer, or a circus artist, I approach them with intuition. Yes, you've got your spell on me, baby.
So, Ramiro, you have been traveling a lot.
Yes.
And I was wondering, did you do these travels for photo projects, or did you combine it with leisure, or maybe even work as an...
A mix of both, but usually I try to do my major projects in photo were done for that purpose. There are exceptions. The only exception that you can see in my Instagram is the China project. Yeah. I can interleave my work with photography.
Yeah. How do you prepare this? You just take a flight, you go there, you bring your camera.
Well, for me, preparing is more than my camera is pretty simple. Mm-hmm. I never had more than one lens with me, two lenses. I have only two fixed lenses. Very simple camera. For preparing for me is more about get acquainted with the environment. I think it's not convenient to get there just because you have a camera. It's very aggressive. Sometimes you do pictures without the intention of doing history, but you have now a document that depicts a part of the life of somebody. So you need to be very, very respectful with whatever you picture.
The thing I learned in the last years is I was thinking so much. I am an engineer, and that is very bad for photography. Mm-hmm. Engineers think everything in terms of equations, math, but you ask for a tip. My tip is don't think so much.
Don't think so much.